Movie.
From Yaoundé, Cameroon, and the University of Kansas, Joel Embiid.
You better start trusting the process.
I always say that everything just happens so fast.
Is this the Tiger Game Series?
I don't want to hear about no process no more.
Philadelphia, for the fourth time in the last 5 years, goes out in the Eastern Conference semis.
I've been through a lot.
But you just gotta prove that you belong on this stage.
Going into this year, I've gone up to another level.
Process that.
But the only way I'll get respect is if I win a championship.
I like that little montage. Whoever cut that, props to them. Could this be Embiid's year? Stephen A., tell me this. Who is more in need of a standout playoff run? Is it Embiid or Harden?
No, I think it's Harden. I think it's Harden by a mile, in my estimation. I mean, listen, Joel Embiid, he got my vote for league MVP. He's the league leading scorer at 33 a game. I think that some would consider him the best big man in the game, even though statistically Jokic is that guy. Even last year, the last 2 years when Jokic was doing what he did, I'd always say I'd prefer Embiid over Jokic. That's just how I feel about it. James Harden is a star and a stud, and I get all of that. But this guy is amongst active players. He's had 149 career playoff games, and he doesn't have a title. And this is how people are looking at him now. You know, you're starting to ask those questions. I mean, it didn't just start. We've been saying it for a while. We understand that the Embiid is the cornerstone of the Sixers franchise, but he needs help, and he needs the help of James Harden. And we know that when James Harden is electrifying, any team he's on is significantly better than when he's not. You talk about Milwaukee, you talk about Boston. Philadelphia has no shot without Harden. They need Harden. They need Harden to step up and be that dude. Now, he don't have to be the dude he was in Houston, averaging over 30, but he certainly needs to be stellar. He can't fold in the playoffs and have those moments like he's had on a number of occasions throughout his career in the postseason. It cannot happen. And everybody knows what Embiid can do, and everybody knows that Embiid doesn't fold under pressure. Harden has to show he's not one of those dudes either, because people have talked about him that way. He's got to show up.
You know what, Stephen A., I respectfully disagree, although I understand where you're coming from. But when we talk about Joel Embiid, we talk about a guy that's most likely going to win the MVP this season. We talk about a guy that has led the league in scoring two consecutive seasons in a row, okay? And a guy that has actually entered his name in the conversation, not only as the best big in the game today, but arguably the best player in the game today. So when I go and I look at those names that are out there, like Steph Curry, like Kevin Durant, like Giannis Antetokounmpo, those guys shown us that it's different levels that they take their game to. In the postseason, even when their teammates don't have it. So I'm ready, and I think it's a need for Embiid to stand out this postseason to elevate. Can he average 40-plus in a series? Can he average more than 10 boards in a series? Can he go out there and average 3 to 4 blocks in a series and be the best player no matter what the others are doing around him? I'm going to go out there and be the best player on the floor to elevate my team to help them win that series. So if Joel Embiid is able to do that, forget what James Harden is bringing to the table, because if Joel Embiid could go out there and average 40 in a series, then you only really need 18 to 20 points from James Harden. You need you about 17 from Tyrese Maxey. So when I look at Joel Embiid and some of the things that he has said, you know, after his games and things to that nature, especially when they played Minnesota, I heard him say, night in and night out, I want to prove that I'm the best player on the floor. Well, you definitely got that opportunity coming this postseason to show that you could take your game from here to here, like we have seen with all the other superstars that his name has entered the conversation with.
Not only are you wrong, you're unfair. because you know how great Boston and Milwaukee are. It is entirely possible, Perk, that Embiid could average 40 and 10 and they still lose because those other teams are getting help. Giannis could go out there and do it, but Jrue Holiday going to show up. Tatum could go out there and do it, but Jaylen Brown going to show up. Embiid needs help just like everybody else. You can't do it by yourself. I understand what you're saying, what you're demanding of him. What I'm saying to you is that he could elevate his play just like you just said. And if James Harden don't show up, they could still lose. James Harden, there have been games where playoff games. He shot 11% from three-point range, 12% from three-point range, 26% from the field. Key games. There's been a series. He's missing 48, 49 three-pointers in the series. These things have happened where he's fallen off. Now, he's had great moments in the postseason as well. So I don't agree with the choke job where everybody tries to malign him like that. But he has to be consistent if they're going to beat a Milwaukee, if they're going to beat a Boston. That's what I'm saying. And I'm saying to you, Embiid can do all those things that you said, and they could still lose. That's why that's unfair.
Yeah, but Stephen, but I want to ask you this. When you talk about Harden and you talk about showing up, at what level do you want him to show up to? Because I just said, I look at Harden, if Joel Embiid could average 40, I'm telling you around that 17 point to 20 point range is
enough.
It is. If Embiid is averaging 40 in the series, it is good enough with the pieces that they have around them with Tyrese Maxey and Tobias Harris.
They got Tobias Harris. They've got Tyrese Maxey. They've got Melton. They've got Shake Milton. I get all of that. What I'm saying to you, when the postseason arrives and the game slows down, okay, and you're the one with the ball in your hands, you're going to have to make some things happen. So if I'm not getting 25 points, 23 to 25 a game from Harden, I want 12 to 15 assists. He got to show up. He got to be big time. That's all I'm saying. Pick your poison, assist, points, whatever. He got to be big time in this series. He can't be just another player.
Big Perk. We got to go. But real quick, is this the year they have to do it if they're going to get it done?
No, I think conference finals is a success for the 76ers. I don't think they have to get it done this year, but they have to get to the conference finals. If anything short of that is a failure.
All right. Still to come. The Suns still have yet to lose with Kevin Durant in the lineup, but can Kawhi and the Clippers put an end to that streak? Who will be the most important player in this heavily anticipated showdown? We get into it, and DeMar DeRozan says his daughter isn't missing.